channel JFET. JFET already we have discussed the classification. JFET means junction field defect transistor. What is this N channel we will discuss here? The JFET, N channel JFET is formed by joining an N-type semiconductor between the two heavily doped P-type semiconductors. This is as usual, as common as BZT, am I right? But this diagram seems to be little bit different. Here the two P-plus regions are looking smaller compared to the N. So is it means the N is very large compared to P? No. In reality, if these three are three regions, this is a P-type semiconductor and this is a P-type semiconductor, both are heavily doped. And this is an N-type semiconductor, normally doped. So these three semiconductors, this is P-type semiconductor, heavily doped. I am representing with P-plus to indicate it is heavily doped. It is also P-plus, means it is also heavily doped semiconductor. But this N-type semiconductor is normally doped. These all three semiconductors, they have almost same size. But to understand the concept of the JFET, we are representing the P plus semiconductors in this way because whenever the carriers are moving, the channel width changes. In future, you can understand this diagram is very easy to understand the concept. Okay? Right. So we have discussed that JFET is, N channel JFET is formed by joining an N type semiconductor, this yellow book, N type semiconductor between the two other semiconductors, two P plus regions. They have almost equal size. Okay, this JFET has three terminals. You can observe here, this is source, drain and gate. Source, drain and gate. And source and drain terminals are taken from the same semiconductor, the same N-type semiconductor, middle, from the yellow book. We are taking two terminals, one is source and another one is drain, through ohmic contacts. In order to connect on our breadboard or whether wherever we require, we are taking through ohmic contacts. So source and drain terminals are taken out through ohmic contacts from the N-type semiconductor. But the gate is the terminal which is taken out by joining the two P-plus regions. I have joined these two books. I have taken a common terminal from that. I am calling that terminal as gate. What are these source, drain, gate terminals? Source is a terminal through which the majority carriers enter into this N-type semiconductor bar. And the drain is the terminal through which the majority carriers leave the semiconductor bar. So source is the terminal through which the majority carriers are entering. Drain is the terminal through which the majority carriers are leaving. Gate is the terminal which controls these majority carriers flow from the source to drain. It is controlling the majority carriers flow. How many majority carriers have to flow? That will be decided by the gate. So source is the terminal through which the majority carriers are entering. Drain is the terminal, majority carriers through which the majority carriers are leaving the bar. But in JFET, one beauty is the source and drain terminals can be interchangeable. That is not possible in the BZT. Emitter and the collector terminals cannot be interchangeable. Here you can observe the similarities between the BZT and JFET. There we have discussed about the emitter. Here the source. Emitter through which the majority carriers are entering. Here the source is the majority, through which the majority carriers are entering. Drain, collector, collecting. Here the drain, through which the majority carriers are leaving. Base, here the gate. But here source and drain terminals can be interchangeable at low frequencies, but they cannot be interchangeable at high frequencies. What is this interchanging concept? Means if you give the supply negative to the source terminal, if you give the same negative supply to the drain terminal, nothing to worry. The electrons will emit from this region to this region. So source and drain terminals can be interchangeable. That is not possible in the BZT. And the source and drain terminals interchanging concept is not possible even at the higher frequencies. Now okay, we have discussed almost all concepts about the JFET. What is this N channel? What is this channel? You can see here, these two p plus regions, two p type semiconductors are forming two p-n junctions here. These two p-n junctions are formed, the two depletion regions are formed, the space between these two depletion regions through which the majority carriers are traveling from source to drain is called channel. Because the space between these two depletion regions is an n-type semiconductor, so this is called as n-channel JFET. If this is a p-type semiconductor and these two heavily doped semiconductors are n plus, means heavily doped n-type semiconductors, then we would have called it as p-channel JFET. Means channel is the space between the two depletion regions through which the majority carriers are traveling from source to drain. Now, this is the construction diagram. It is very difficult to connect this diagram in the circuit. So, in order to connect in the circuit, we are taking the circuit diagram. This is the circuit diagram of the N-channel JFET. Whereas in the BZT, we have seen the cross lines. Here, straight. Straight paths, straight lines you can observe here. This is a JFET. The arrow direction here at the gate terminal. This is an N-channel JFET and this is a P-channel JFET. In the BZT, the arrow symbol is represented at the emitter. Okay? This is the construction of N-channel JFET.